Yes, and Saturday night, and I must tell you, the mouth of the South, Jimmy Hart, here with the Taskmaster and the lovely Jacqueline, you keep proving points just week after week.
You know, Lee, when I'm standing next to the Taskmaster, Kevin Sullivan, and Jacqueline, I feel like I'm as safe as in the vault of Fort Knox, because they are definitely the most dominant force in professional wrestling today.
I was reminded of an old R&B lyric that said, I'm not dropping you, but I am putting you up for a little while. That's kind of your relationship. You had the relationship, now you picked each other back up.
No, I've never let her go, you see. There's a difference in life between staying together and living together. We've always been together. Jackie has never left my heart. Jackie didn't give up. This is life we're talking about. She's been with me through thick and thin.
Well, the people are certainly with her. They chant your name now at arenas. They call for you to, well, pretty much take action against anybody that's in the ring with the Taskmaster. But I want to bring something up, and we've sort of been around this before, but there's a new piece of videotape.
Whoa, wait a minute, Lee. Yeah. If this is another Nancy and Chris Benoit tape, we don't want to see it.
All right, you need to keep it to yourself. We don't want to see it. Okay, forget it.
I know.
It's not a Nancy Chris Benoit tape, but it is a tape that I really do think. Serious. Kevin, I'm very serious with you. This is a tape that I really think you're going to want to see, and you too. As a matter of fact, we can go to the truck and have them roll that video, please.
This message is for you, Kevin Sullivan. Nancy, you knew when you met him he was no good. You know how he always said on his mother's deathbed she told him he was no good, but it wasn't his fault? Well, I was in the same room with him, and I loved her more than he did. She was wrong. It is his fault.
Kevin, I hope you know that we really needed to show you that. I mean, this is now like, this is above and beyond. This is,
how could you, Kevin?
I had nothing to do with sending the tape. I just had to show it. Listen, I understand it's really well be, I'm really, well, folks, we're going to the room.
Hey, that was startling, and I'm not, you know, I'm not so sure who that was in that videotape, but it looked like to me that was Kevin's son, Ben.
Well, let me tell you what.
That really shocked Kevin Sullivan, didn't it?
Yeah, it shocked me.
Is that who it was? I'm not sure.
And the shock or the emotion that's going through the Taskmaster right now, I mean, brother, I'm going to tell you what. I'm going to move on to something else. That's too...
Yeah,
that's too deep for me right there.
I don't think we need to go there right now.
That should have been shown, to tell you the truth.
And I agree with that.
Yeah, wow.
I agree with that. I'm not so sure
that was unreal.
If that should have been shown or not.
But Snagger Lee always pulls it out of hand.
Well, you know, I mean, when we saw the video on Benoit and Woman, he almost beat me up and beat Lee up.
I know him.
So I'm not going to go there, fans.
No.
But we are going to show now a member of the Dungeon of Doom, Hugh Morrus, against Villano 4.
Who?
Villano 4.
There's four guys against this one.
No, he's the fourth in the series of men who have donned the mask from Mexico, calling themselves Villano.
Oh, yes, I like it. Thank you, Mr. Sanchez. Okay, number four, Villano, is in there with Hugh Morrus.
Still to come, Harlem Heat against Renegade and Joe Gomez, Public Enemy, Bunkhouse Buck, Mike Enos. Double main event tonight this uncensored weekend here on Saturday night.
We're on a roll getting ready to go in uncensored. Hugh Morrus, speed, power, can move like a lightweight, like a cruiserweight at 300 and something pounds. And number four of the Villano boys in there trying to go ahead and make a victory here.
Double kip up and now to the full-arm dragon twist, and the big man goes to the ropes.
That were great bullfighters in Mexico like that. That was one, two, three, and four, and six. Five got gored, and they left him out. You know what I mean?
I don't know anything about bullfighting.
I love bullfighting, man. I sit at the Plaza de Toros in Madrid, Spain, a little bar across the street. I love that place. I love going to bullfight.
Over the top. Good move by Villano, and he tries to make a cover. Oh, boy.
See the power.
The power of Hugh Morrus. Not only that, Hugh Morrus quickly to the point of attack once the man is up to his feet, and there's a running lariat from the near side ropes.
He's stagging full Vianos right there. He got them all, brother.
Yes.
I mean, you see him stagger back.
Four generations of Vianos.
And these guys are great athletes. You know, I'll be kidding about the name a little bit. In Mexico, they are well-renowned. I mean, they are known all over. And they are from a great family and great athletes. But I just believe he's outmatched here with Hugh Morrus.
Many people have said that. Hugh Morrus, trilateral press, pulls off of it with a big smile on his face. Certainly one of the oddest men we've ever seen. And now these reverse kicks are on target. And a DDT from Villano. Yeah. Boy, how about that?
Excuse me. Well, he should have tried to cover him.
Boy, you're not kidding. How many?
And should have grabbed him around the neck.
Boy, that is odd. I mean,
because that was a nice move, and he drilled him. Had him laying prone, should have went for the cover.
First time I've ever seen a man execute a DDT.
And grab a headlock.
And grab a headlock. You're right. Well, that has to be part of that style that we're unaccustomed to.
Well, it's coming back to haunt him.
Yeah, we've seen the high-risk flying maneuvers from the athletes from Mexico, but nothing like that before, fans. And here we go. Hugh Morrus back in it. Picks him up. Head scissor takeover. Great balance by Villano Four. He ducked the clothesline. Saw that one coming. Oh, and he's caught. Nobody. Yeah. Small package. Put him over. One, two. I think he's underneath the ropes. He is.
Yeah, somehow Fulviano's got a round on him and got him kind of in a position to go ahead and get a 1-2-3, but it just made him mad. I'm talking about Hugh Morrus. What kind of state of mind are the Dungeon and Doom guys in with knowing just what we've seen in an emotional roller coaster that the Taskmaster's on? I'm telling you, that was something, fans. Uncensored right here around the corner. On his legs. Break them both.
No laughing matters what it's called, and there's no smile out of the face of Hugh Morrus on this one.
But he had a harder time with Villano 4. I'm telling you that he might have thought he was.
Villano 4 took him right, pushed him right to the limit here on WCW Saturday night. Well, fans, as you know, another great matchup is going to feature Glacier and a man we first saw last week on this program, Morrus. We're going to take a look at their matchup in just a few moments. But right now, here's the replay once again on Saturday Night Dream.
Well, Villano 4 went ahead and took to task the show of trying to stop this big, agile man that we call Hugh Morrus. No laughing matter. Going to hook it in to the pay window for one man that's on the rise here in WCW.
Stay with us on this uncensored weekend on the Superstation.